My City Real World Conference will be attended by 60 young activists from 10 different countries and 16 major cities around the world. They have arrived in Belfast for a 3-day conference to talk about policing, sharing experiences and discussing how to combat stereotypes that shape interactions with police.
It's been a long held ambition of mine to hold the My City Real World Conference in Belfast. We had colleagues who went to some of the earlier conferences, and I felt very strongly that Belfast needed a conference like this because we need to learn from some of your excellent practice from across the world.
But we now have very accountable structures. We have built respect for human rights on both sides, and that has certainly underpinned the policies and the practices and the procedures and decision-making implemented by the police.
We're all here to put the ideas into the ring and figure out how we go forward to move away from racial or ethnic profiling and into the new relationship. So thank you again for having us. We really look forward to spending the next few days together.
I expect to meet a lot of nice people, to share information, to share practices, to learn. And yeah, that's it, pretty much. Yeah.
I'm expecting to have the opportunity to share my research with Stopwatch regarding policing and safeguarding children. And I'm also expecting to learn a lot from the experiences of the other delegates and kind of understand more about the issues around policing on an international level.
Over the conference, we heard from an all-female panel about the history and reality of policing in Northern Ireland.
It's extremely difficult to shift an organisation away from its initial conditions, particularly in the kind of context that we were in Northern Ireland. So what are the kind of things that allowed policing change to work? Because I think policing change did work.
The police needed to be publicly accountable, held publicly accountable through the policing board and through the police ombudsman's investigations, and I'm sure Nuala will speak more about that, but those were extremely important confidence building measures as well.
In most places, the police investigate the police, and that leads to mistrust. In Northern Ireland, that is not the case. In Northern Ireland, the police ombudsman investigates the police. And you know, there are a variety of reasons why things go wrong. Political interference. Across the world, there's political interference in policing.
Transparency has, to some extent, I believe, been ensured by offices such as the Police Ombudsman making public the reports, but by the Policing Board publishing annual reports and some intense scrutiny of individual areas. For example, you've heard mentioned stop and search, policing with children, young people, domestic violence, etc.
It's been a really great conference. The panel this morning with the women involved in the Northern Ireland Police was really fascinating, and I think one of the best panels I've ever seen, just start to finish as far as knowledge and expertise. And
I'm from The Hague, the Netherlands, and we're experiencing a lot of problems with the police, ethnic profiling and excessive police violence against mostly foreign youth. And I have heard a lot of ideas and suggestions that we can implement in The Hague.
It's important to bring people together, like to hear to each other and, you know, try to find solutions, although that's not always the case because, for example, I'm from Brazil and it's a very different situation from here. But still, bringing people together and talking is always a good solution.
Then began the speed dating sessions that looked at an overview of specific organisations presenting their work.
It's important because, like, not everyone knows what everyone else is doing, so then you can pick up stuff, and then also you realise that some people are doing the same thing as you, so you can like connect, and like it's like really networking, so it's really good to have it because you meet new people, you get more information, you get new things.
Workshops followed, focusing on ethnic and racial profiling, evaluation theories, and looking at working with the police successfully.
For me personally, I had no idea that there was this global movement of young people addressing the serious issue. So it's opened my mind to a whole lot of possibilities. But I've already learned a lot about other people's strategies, you know, and things that I can try in my hometown. But also that there's a community that I can connect the young people I worked with to, which always makes difficult work easier when you have comrades in that work.
Because I think it's quite easy when you're working on one issue to get bogged down in the national situation or in that specific situation you're working in. And when you come to something that's much bigger, you get an appreciation of how that fits into a wider like truth about injustice and inequality and kind of controlling communities. So I think it takes something like this for people to appreciate that.
I think this kind of international conference is really important for the youth, for the communities, for the countries where we come from, because every country has their issue, but if you share the issues, suddenly it could feel like my problem is not maybe like big as their problem, but we can learn and we can share, and that is the most important of this kind of event.
So it's just been great in terms of, I come from a political science academic background, and I'm really interested in how those types of ideas play out on the ground level, and so it's been great talking to community organizers and hearing a lot of the same ideas that I talk about in terms of relations and power dynamics, but just phrased somewhat differently and very, very much sort of grounded in the real world. It's been fantastic.
And we've learned a lot from Belfast and from the other people here present.
I realized when we were talking that we were sometimes forgetting one point. We were talking about that we want to empower our communities. It's about empowering ourselves. And when we are empowered, each of us is empowered. Our communities will get empowered. Empowering is that's the individual process, I think. And the other ones are the structural process. Processes, and I really wanted to say this again, and I feel really empowered by all the people I met here in the discussions. Really, thank you.
This is Fintan Murray reporting from My City Real World, Belfast, 2014.